Welcome to the committee. Please introduce yourself for the record.
Good afternoon, Madam Chair, members of the committee. Thank you for the opportunity to say a few words. And thank you, Representative Mariano, for bringing this bill forward. My name is Randy Anderson, and I'm a person living in long-term recovery. And what that means to me is I haven't had to use drugs, alcohol, or any mood-altering substance since January 9, 2005. I'm also a state-licensed alcohol and drug counselor and a formerly incarcerated individual due to drug-related offenses. We hear this false dichotomy that there's only two stances on this issue, incarceration or legalization, which I believe actually is commercialization. I strongly believe that there's a better way forward than incarceration. There's a better way forward than commercialization, and we need to be devoting our resources, our time, our energy to finding a path between those two extremes. It's well known that when a substance becomes legal, perceived harm, especially with adolescence, is significantly reduced. And when perceived harm goes down, use increases. According to one of our nation's leading scientists, Dr. Nora Volko, director of the National Institute on Drug Abuse, the greatest mortality from drugs comes from legal drugs. The moment you make a drug legal, you're going to increase the number of people who get exposed to it, and therefore you increase the negative consequences from its use. When you legalize, you create an industry whose purpose is to make money selling those drugs. And how do you sell it? Mostly by enticing people to take them and entice them to take high quantities. In the 70s, 80s, and even into the 90s, THC levels, THC, the main psychoactive compound in marijuana that gives the high sensation, averaged between 2% and 4%. By 2014, THC levels hovered around 14%. Thanks to sophisticated farming, cloning techniques, and the demand of users to get a stronger high more quickly, selective breeding has resulted in average marijuana potency of 20% THC. Some strains exceed 30%. Marijuana concentrates and extracts, much more commonly used in the last 5 years, have THC levels that range from 40 to more than 80%. That is according to the Marijuana Industry Promotional Information and Drug Enforcement Administration reports. Researchers do not yet know the full extent of consequences when the body and the brain, especially developing brain, are exposed to high concentrations of THC. According to the National Center on Addiction and Substance Abuse in Columbia University, 90% of those people with addiction began using alcohol or other drugs before turning 18. I would also add, I think a member of the committee could be someone in addiction recovery from marijuana use. Regardless of what my state, our state, decides the next step should be, I recommend we move slow and cautiously forward and allow all voices to be heard for and against the commercialization of marijuana. In closing, I would pose the question, what is it we are attempting to accomplish? It's more than obvious the war on drugs failed, so continuing those types of policies benefits no one. However, from an addiction treatment recovery perspective, do we really want to introduce another intoxicating substance and make it more widely available in our communities? Thank you.
Thank you so much.